In this video, we'll be going over the whys, hows, and wheres of backing up your Wii U games and system data, for both safekeeping and to use on other systems. Starting with the whys, why would you actually want to back up your Wii U games? After all, they're already saved on your system or on a disk. You may not intend to buy another Wii U at any point in time, and anything that you don't want on your system right now could always be re-downloaded from the Nintendo eShop, even after its closure on March 27th, 2023. Well, the first reason is actually the eShop's closure. While March 27th, 2023 only marks the date when games can no longer be purchased from the eShop, it's also the start of an invisible countdown to a future date when all Wii U servers shut down permanently, and even games purchased before the original cutoff date can no longer be re-downloaded. To be clear, there's no current announcement for something like that actually happening, and it will likely be a very long time before the Wii U's lose all of their connections to purchase histories. But whether it happens in 2 years or 20 years, having a solid backup of everything on your system makes sure that nothing gets lost if the servers are down and if your Wii U actually stops working. And your Wii U will eventually stop working. Hardware failure is inevitable for all systems, and as someone who repairs consoles in his spare time, we kind of just hope those failures are actually repairable. Unfortunately, there are clearly some failures out there for the Wii U right now that are already unrepairable. We recently bought this Wii U as a backup device to use for a future video. While it originally booted without an issue, anytime I attempted to play a game, it provided a NAND memory error code. Then, after a few attempts, it's just not displaying an image anymore. The issue appears to be something to do with the NAND chip housing the system's internal storage, with a permanent fix likely requiring me to swap the memory chip on the motherboard. Some research shows that this issue is uncommon, but becoming more likely over time, especially for Wii U's sitting in storage going unused. While your Wii U may not fail in the same way, these sorts of issues tend to crop up over time for any computer, and who knows when a random failure will lock you out of your downloads or game saves. Better safe than sorry. But honestly, even beyond support ending and hardware failure, one of the main reasons to back up your games and system data is just because you can. You own these games. You've dedicated time to playing these games. There's no reason not to make it so that you can take what you have and make it accessible away from your system. Wii U emulation is also great for tinkering, boosting game performance, and having fun modifying a game like Mario Kart 8. To add content created by the community. All of it works to extend the lifespan and viability of some really fantastic games, and there's no downside to that. Okay, so now that we've gone over why you should create a backup, let's step through how to actually do it. First up, make sure you have the following items. 1. A functioning Wii U that can connect to the internet. Seems obvious, but if your Wii U doesn't turn on and you don't have an internet access, this method won't work. 2. A 32GB SD card. A larger SD card could technically be used, but it'll require some additional formatting, and so far I've only seen Xenoblade Chronicles X complete with its DLC take more than 32GB to download. And then 3. A USB storage device. This is technically optional, but highly recommended. Essentially, if you have a ton of digital games associated with your system, the 8 or 32GB of internal storage on your system will be a pain to work with, since you'll ultimately need to do some heavy storage management to back up everything. If you're only backing up your games, a high-capacity flash drive will do just fine. I personally use a 128GB drive that I have permanently plugged into the back of my console. It's been working just fine for a couple of years, although recently, it's been starting to show some failures. If you want to use your storage to regularly play games on your Wii U, though, you might want to shell out for a dedicated external hard drive. Flash drives are great in a pinch, but have a higher rate of failure if they're constantly being accessed. In a scenario like this, A hard drive, especially one with a dedicated power source, will tend to last longer and have a lower rate of failure. Once you have those three items, you're pretty much ready to go. The process we're going over for this video is called dumpling. The Cemu setup guide, which we'll have linked in the description, has a great reference on how to use it and troubleshoot any problems you might have. Though overall, the main points are that 1, this method uses a browser exploit and doesn't require modifying your console any, great for folks like me, who love using original unmodified hardware, and 2, it'll take you less than 5 minutes to get up and running. Okay, here are the steps. Step 1. With your Wii U turned off, insert your SD card and connect any USB storage devices. Step 2. Power on the Wii U and download or insert the games you want to back up. Step 3. Log into your Nintendo account and make sure all updates and DLC, if applicable, have been downloaded for those games. Step 4. Open your internet browser and go to dumplingapp.com. Once the page loads, click Launch Dumpling to get started. What happens from here is that the website loads some script onto your machine in order to run a custom application. This application will delete itself when you turn off your console, which, again, is great if you don't want to go through the process of actually modifying your console permanently. If, while attempting to load the application, your system appears to freeze for over a minute, hold down the power button on your console to shut it down. Then restart it, clear your browser's data, and attempt to run Dumpling again. This happens to me every couple dozen times I've tried to launch the app, so don't expect it to be overly common if it happens to you on your first attempt. Step 5. If you have a physical game inserted, select Dump a Game Disc to get started. Otherwise, choose Dump Digital Games, select which of your downloaded games to back up, and press the plus button to start the process. When it asks if you want to dump updates and DLC files, select yes. Finally, it'll show you where the game data will be saved and some extra data regarding your account. By default, your SD card will be listed as unnamed. That's perfectly fine. Just select confirm to move forward. After confirming, Dumpling will examine the size of the game data you're looking to back up and compare that to the space left on your storage device. As long as you have enough space available, it should proceed without any additional intervention. In general, backing up a single game takes less than about 15 minutes. Though extremely large games like Xenoblade Chronicles X may take quite a bit longer. So just remember to be patient. Still, whenever it's done, it'll let you know how much time it took and kick you back to the Dumpling menu. Step 6. Exit the Dumpling menu to shut down your console. To avoid any data issues, make sure to only remove your SD card after your console is fully shut down. When it is, eject your SD card from your Wii U, plug the SD card into whatever computer you'd like to use to store your game data, and copy all your files to an accessible directory. When fully copied, you can delete all the files on that card. And that's really all there is to it. In general, backing up a single game takes less than 15 minutes each on average. Although that might vary depending on the size of the game and any general updates to Dumpling in the future. Now that you have at least one game backed up to a hard drive, you might be wondering where to go to use that file away from your Wii U. Currently, there's only one real answer. Cemu. The best Wii U emulator around, and really the only Wii U emulator around. First, go to cemu.info and scroll to the bottom of the page, click Download Latest Experimental Version to navigate to the GitHub repository containing the latest releases, then click the Assets menu to expand the download option. As of this video, Cemu is supported on x86 systems running Windows, macOS, Ubuntu, and at least the Steam Deck OS flavor of Arch Linux. Windows on ARM computers don't have sufficient emulation abilities to launch games in a playable manner through Cemu, but ARM-based macOS computers do have enough horsepower to run Cemu via Rosetta. Regardless of the operating system you're using, setup is pretty much the same all around. Start by downloading the file applicable to your system, either install the app or extract the zip file, then open the application. Initial setup will ask you to specify some setting, including whether you want to download community files and the location on your computer where you saved your Wii U game. Point the program in the right direction, hit OK until you're in the app itself. If you don't see any games listed, right-click on an empty portion of the screen and select Refresh Games List. If you still don't see anything, check that your games are in the right folder and that the game path in the Options General Settings menu is pointing to the expected folder. When in doubt, you can use the File menu to load your game manually. Similarly, you can use the Install DLC option to install any updates or DLC you dumped from your Wii U. Simply click the option, locate the folder, and choose to open the folder. After that, make sure to set up your controller through Options Input Settings. For this, simply fill in the blank options as needed. I'm using an Xbox Series X controller here, acting as a Wii U Pro controller. Once that's set up, the only thing left to do is to double-click a game to start it running. In general, if you followed all those steps, the game should at least run without any additional hassles. Though, know that there's no guarantee that the game will run well. That all depends on what system you're using. From personal experience, I can confirm that the games tend to run great on my desktop, which has an i7 processor and 3060 graphics card, my M1 Pro MacBook Pro, and my Steam Deck. If a game isn't running as expected, you can check your general settings menu to see if there are any graphic settings you can tweak to increase performance. Making sure your graphics API is set to Vulkan, if possible, is often a good idea. Additionally, you can check out the graphics packs created by the community for the games you want to play. Just select Options, Graphics Packs, download latest community graphics packs, and start browsing the options. Not all graphics packs will be useful, nor will all the useful packs increase performance, but they at least provide you some flexibility to fine-tune your experience and, in some cases, patch some emulation issues. Now that you've backed up your games and set up a way to play those games away from your Wii U, you're all set. All that's left is to just have some fun playing. A few final recommendations though. If you're using Cemu and have the space on your screen, remember to click Options Separate Gamepad View to show both the TV and gamepad screens at the same time. For some games, that's not useful, of course, but it's game-changing for others. Along those same lines, try out a dual-screen setup if you ever have the chance. Leaving both screens visible is great for recreating the Wii U experience and can be really fun to tinker with. My personal favorite setup is a dual-screen Steam Deck. It's hyper-portable, emulates Wii U games well, and has a similar overall feel to the gamepad when playing. If you're interested, check out the link in the video description for our setup guide for that. If you'd like to take any of your backups and restore them to your Wii U, also consider installing some custom firmware. On top of restoring files, it'll allow you to use the Wii U's backwards compatibility with GameCube files and emulate a variety of different systems. These days, software modifications are easy to install and have really concrete guides to walk you through the process. Eventually, we'll have our own walkthrough posted on this channel, and you'll see a link above my head when that actually happens. But until then, you can check out the link in the description for the Wii U Hacks website. Okay, that was a lot of info, and I hope it was useful to y'all. If it was, go ahead and click that like button to let me know. Of course, if you followed along and had any pain points or would like to make suggestions for future folks dumping their games for the first time, feel free to leave a comment down below to let us know how that went. In our next video, we'll be moving on to backing up your 3DS games, which is a bit more involved, but still a pretty simple process. Make sure you're subscribed so that you don't miss out on that. And if you'd like to support me making more guides like this, be sure to check out our Patreon for early releases for these videos and exclusive content. That's all for this video though. Until next time, catch you later.